Well, folks, it was more than half a decade in the making, but yesterday, Michael Cohen, Donald Trump's former lawyer slash fixer, finally got his revenge against his former employer. And it, of course, happened in a Manhattan courtroom where Donald Trump is standing trial along with his two adult sons and his company as a whole for allegedly, well, not even allegedly, because their guilt has already been determined, but for defrauding the state of New York, defrauding banks, and basically defrauding everybody else along the way. And Cohen testified yesterday that he was instructed to, essentially, as he put it, reverse engineer the numbers that Donald Trump would give to him. Here's the way Cohen described it in court. I was tasked by Mr. Trump to increase the total assets based upon a number that he arbitrarily elected. And my responsibility, along with Allen Weisselberg predominantly, was to reverse engineer the various asset classes, increase those assets to achieve the number that Mr. Trump asked us. Then they asked him, well, which number? And Cohen responded, whatever Mr. Trump told us to. So it wasn't just one particular number. It wasn't just one time he would come in and do this, I guess, regularly, based on Cohen's testimony. He would write down a number in red pen. He would never put it on the record, right? It was never in an email. It was never in an official memo. And according to forensics experts, Trump wrote it in red pen because that is the one that shows up the poorest when you do a black and white copy of a document. So Trump would write it in red pen, hand the number to Michael Cohen, and Cohen and Weisselberg and maybe even others, you know, don't know yet, he's going to continue testifying today, would then look at that number and say, okay, we have to engineer these assets that we have and inflate their numbers just enough to become the new number that Donald Trump wants as the total. And of course, this number was not only given out to people in the media when Donald Trump wanted to brag about his assets, it was given to banks, may have been used for tax purposes, again, waiting on more confirmation from today's testimony. But things didn't go well for Donald Trump yesterday, to say the least. And I think Cohen enjoyed it. I think Cohen even enjoyed when Donald Trump lawyer Christopher Keese jumped up dramatically and objected to a statement that Cohen had made, that the objection was in fact overruled by Ingeron, but the objection was so dramatic by Christopher Keese that, according to reports, laughter erupted in the courtroom because it looked like something you would see in a bad movie. Just like Donald Trump's lawyers look like lawyers you would see in a bad movie, because clearly they're not super great at their job. But kudos to Michael Cohen for not only blowing the lid open on all this and, you know, admitting that this is what happened, but kudos to him for finally getting his revenge. I think at this point, Michael Cohen has earned it. He deserved that moment, and I hope he enjoyed it. The only issue with any of this, of course, is that Michael Cohen is technically, you know, a convicted criminal. So his testimony, unfortunately, carries a little bit less weight in court simply due to that fact. So it may not be the smoking gun we want it to be. It may not be as powerful in terms of the final decision-making of the judge as we'd like it to be. But for Cohen, it's what he's been waiting years to do, and he finally got to do it yesterday. And as I said, he's going to do it even more today. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.